It's a jolly holiday with Mary. Mary looks hot, so light. Hi guys, welcome back to Twins to Amps. Today I have my annual play and it's actually a musical called Mary Poppins. And I am the character Bert and I'll be bringing you guys along with me. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Okay guys, I'm all ready to go. And this is my second outfit. You'll be seeing me in it later on the stage. And this is the outfit I'm going to wear in the park. And I hope you guys like my acting and the play. So yeah, I'm going now. Bye! Come along, guys.
What's your character about?
I'm actually a very good friend of Mary Poppins, and I'm actually a chimney sweeper. But I look neat right now, though. The play is starting at 6 p.m. It's 4 p.m. right now. We're going to practice it once or maybe twice, and I'm feeling a tiny bit nervous right now.
You'll do fine. I know that.
Hopefully.
Hello guys, so as you all know that it's our sister's annual play and she went to her school at around 4 o'clock. Now we are going to go to her school and we are going to see how she performs.
I'm really excited to see my sister's performance and grab some popcorn and see her play.
Precision and order, that's all that I ask. The running up and house, a straightforward task. The children, the servants, are all your domain. To put serum in the serum of cherry treating. Oh, the simple truth is that you've been in six nannies in the last 4 months, and they all have been unqualified disasters. A nanny should govern, a nanny should rule. A nanny is a paragon who suffers no fool. A nanny is taller. Our children would gain by having such a nanny in Cherry Tree Lane.
I thought Tracy Nana would be fun with the children. She always looks so cross.
Winifred, never give yourself a chance with a liver complaint. Umbrella.
No, George, what?
So take control. Obstetricians, show your authority when interviewing staff. You know your role, they know their stations.
We face. Oh, only if we could find someone like you, Nanny.
My friend, never give yourself a chance to deliver something.
Father, what's that you're holding here? We've written our own advertisement.
What on?
George, we should hear it.
No, Winifred, one of your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen. Wanted, a nanny for two adorable children.
Adorable? Well, you've lost a bit, but I must say.
If you want the choice position, have a cheery disposition. Rosy cheeks, no warts, play games. All sorts, you must be kind, you must be witty. Very sweet and very pretty.
Well, off all the ridiculous.
George, please. Take us on outings, give us treats. Sing songs, break sweets, and never be cross or cruel. Never be the stature or cruel. Love is as a son and daughter. Never smell of barley water. If you won't scold us, dominate us, we will never give you a cause to hate us. We will tie your spectacles so you can't see. Put dogs in your bed or pepper in your tea. Hurry, nanny, many thanks, sincerely, Jane and Michael, thanks.
Well, that's a tutorial for one day. Now what did you just go up, young lady? Let me get to work.
They were only trying to help.
It won't help anyone making me late.
Precision and
household a straightforward task. The children, the servants are all your domain.
And in the land of enchanted now, my friend, if you do want these beans,
you know I do, George.
Very well. Come please an advertisement. The dying city, the Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
I will finish it all out of the fire.
We need you to be only perfect in every way.
Well, those are my credentials.
Something as plain as a park becomes a wonderland. All you have to do is look at you, then you'll understand. Why? It's a jolly holiday with Mary. Mary makes your heart so light. When the day is gray and ordinary, happiness is blooming all around her. The daffodils are smiling at the dove.
You do talk nonsense.
When Mary holds your hand, you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band. Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder it's Mary that we love. Come on, you two.
Never interrupt a father.
Were you ever a little boy?
Of course I was a little boy.
but my nanny, Miss Ann, soon became out. What about your mother?
I shouldn't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
Didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Poor father.
Poor? What do you mean by poor? That's what made me the man I am. Oh.
You don't say.
Well, here she is now. You can tell yourself.
That is Doc's dog, Willoughby.
Don't interrupt when someone's barking.
You were saying...
Ready.
Well, if she keeps wandering off like that, perhaps it would be better if you kept on a lead.
Mrs. Willoughby might be on her way right now.
It really feels like she's missing out on a lot. Here she comes now.
How do you learn to talk dog?
How do you think? Master the grammar.
Practice when you can.
And avoid mongrels. Far too much slang. Now, come along. I can't stand here all day talking shop.
Talking shop? What a silly expression.
There's nothing silly about it. Not in the least.
What do you buy in a talking shop?
Conversations, of course.
Well, I've never seen a talking shop.
She talked to William before he went conquering, to a lad before he went impaling, and to Alexander when he weren't so great.
We'll have to call her shop in the park then.
There's no shop in the park.
Now remember, anything can happen if you let it.
That's it! I'm out of conversations!
Good day to you, Mrs. Corey.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Mary Poppins. With Jane and Michael back?
She knows us?
Of course I do. How's Paul into Georgie?
Who?
Georgie Banks, your father. He used to give his nanny the slip and coming in here a secret.
It couldn't have been the same George Banks.
That would have been 40 years ago. George, you always saved the stars. Now, Mary, what can I do for you?
Well, I did want an ounce of conversations.
I'm all out of conversations and I'm right out of words too. You see, I had a lot of chatter boxes in here today, but let me see what we have. I do have some
U, C, L, and V.
Seven more.
I'll pick A, F, S, T, E, O, and P.
And I choose NX!
I see a dog and a cat.
Rutabag, that's nine.
Leptopris, that's 11, nearly there.
That's not a word, you just made it up.
And where do you think words come from in the first place? Someone has to make them up.
You know, you could always use the same letter more than twice. Now let me see. Super, Alice, Regali, Dosha.
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, it can rather prove a useful one. When trying to express oneself is frankly quite sad, to leap through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation clean. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Super loud enough, you always sound precocious. Super califragilistic, expialidocious. Chatting, simply grunting would suffice.
Oh, if they heard this word, they might have used it once or twice.
And your Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in a jiff. Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Oh, supercalifragilistic, expialidocious. Say it and wild animal, maxims or ferocious. And some father flourishes, it's pseudococcocious. making tices halitosis. Of course, you can say it backwards, which is to your epididymis, the second synagogue, and the creepus.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
Smarty pants.